Hello and welcome to the fifth episode in our series on dementia. In this episode, we will try to understand the behavioral problems associated with dementia and how to manage these behavioral issues in subjects with dementia. Come, let us meet our expert.
The common behavioral problems seen in people with dementia, or mainly Alzheimer's disease, is that you have a multiple problems like hallucinations, delusions. So in hallucinations and delusions, the person sees certain things or has certain beliefs which the other family members do not share. In addition to that, there can be various mood symptoms, like the person could be sad, person could be anxious, you could be agitated. Some patients could be apathetic or not interested in doing anything. Some persons might have physical symptoms like being agitated, being restless, wandering around in the night. Some people might have problems with having inappropriate behavior, like they might behave inappropriately, or they might take off their clothes, or they might behave in a sexually inappropriate fashion. Some persons might have difficulties, other behavioral problems and other activities of daily living problems which the family members might face, is the fact that they are not able to take care of their daily activities like bathing, eating, you know, having their bath or going to brush their teeth or shave and so on. These are the common behavioral symptoms that are there. Now, these behavioral symptoms are a part and parcel of the dementing illness. Behavioral symptoms are the ones that usually make the family come to the hospital and seek help. Because many times for the memory symptoms, family members and patients themselves may not come because they think it's part of normal aging. Though it is not part of normal aging, and we should educate the public that any memory problem needs to be consulted with the doctor. So the behavioral symptoms, it is well known that in different stages of dementia can be divided into mild, moderate and severe. Now in the mild stage of dementia, usually the person has some difficulties in addition to memory problems and other cognitive symptoms. The person usually has difficulties with activities outside the house, what is called as instrumental activities. So going to the bank, going for shopping, doing complicated things like, you know, complicated cooking. These are the things that happen in mild stage. In the moderate stage of dementia, usually the person is not fully aware as he would be in the mild stage. So a person starts having difficulties with activities of daily living in the house. So for example, he'll start having difficulties with, especially to start off with, very complicated activities like having a bath, maybe operating a remote of a TV, or other activities that he's supposed to do, you know, how he should change his clothes, how he should choose his clothes and choose different clothes. So these kind of daily activities will become problematic. And in the severe stage, the person becomes fully dependent on the caregiver and he is not able to do many things on his own. So in the mild stage, because the person is aware to some extent about his memory problems, the person, the usual behavioral symptoms that he has is things like anxiety, depression, he gets panicky, he keeps repeating and asking many questions again and again to say that, you know, have I said this, what have I said, what did you say, who is coming. So he keeps asking various questions to remind himself. This is a common behavioral symptom that is there in the mild stage. By the time moderate stage comes, the memory problems are more serious, and so they can start getting these ideas that I said earlier on, that, you know, somebody stolen my things, or, you know, I'm being taken away to some other house, or I want to go back to my own house, or I'm seeing some people in the house. or, you know, being totally apathetic and not being able to do anything. So that is the symptoms that occurs in the moderate stage. While in the severe stage, there might be severe restlessness and agitation. There might be, the person might just go on screaming and shouting. The person may not sleep at all. He might be just going on remaining awake in the night and just going on talking, just some uttering some nonsensical terms. These are the kind of symptoms that are there in the severe stage. So the behavioral problems which are seen in a patient, as well as the problems with activities of daily living, can be managed easily by training family members. So there is very good evidence that training family members of people with dementia can help to ameliorate these behavioral symptoms. So there are three principles involved in training family members, and that is, first of all, give them education and knowledge about what is this illness that they are facing, what are the symptoms of dementia, what are the clinical features, what is the treatment that is available, what are they likely to face in terms of the course, how long are this problem likely to go on, what are the different behavioral symptoms that they face, and so on. The second aspect is to train family members how to manage these behavioral symptoms. So we can use training principles, which are behavioral training principles, which can be there to coach family members about how to handle these problems better. For example, if a person is agitated, you might tell them how to take care of the agitation by maybe taking the person outside, going for a walk, engaging in more activities and exercise, cognitively stimulating the person, and so on. The third aspect and very important aspect of this caregiver support and training is to get the caregivers to take care of themselves. Because caregivers face a lot of burden. About 50% of caregivers get symptoms of depression or anxiety very commonly in women who are caregivers. In men who are caregivers, they develop various physical complaints and physical symptoms. So taking care of yourself as a caregiver to avoid burnout is an extremely important part of caregiving and support.
This concludes the fifth episode in our series on dementia. In this episode, we focused on behavioral problems associated with dementia and how to manage them. We'll be back with our next episode. Namaste.